Welcome back to my channel, guys. Today we're going to be talking about which of my perfumes I would repurchase once they're out, which ones I will just kind of let go once they're through, or if there's some I might want to get rid of even sooner. So if you're interested in a nice long perfume video, then stay tuned. Okay, so let's start out with the ones that are actually in sight here, which is on my dresser, on my shelf, and on my nighttime tray. And most of these should be ones that I would theoretically repurchase because they are some of my favorites. That's why they're sitting out. But that might not necessarily be the case. Just because you're enjoying something doesn't mean you would necessarily repurchase it. Okay, so let's start off with the Chloé Absolu de Parfum. I've talked about this one quite a few times. It's really nice. Would I repurchase it? Honestly, I'm on the fence about this one because it's really nice, but it doesn't have a huge presence, and it's not one of my absolute favorite daytime perfumes. It's kind of just a nice one to put on when you don't know what to wear, but it is very classy, and I do like it. I do like it quite a bit. So you know what? I think every girl needs a Chloé fragrance in her collection, so I'm going to say that yes, I would rebuy a Chloé fragrance. Hermès Ombre, no, sorry, not Ombre. Where is it? No, this is Hermès Eau de Mervaille. This one, I don't think I would repurchase. I really like this one. My boyfriend actually bought it for me. It was a gift, so I didn't technically actually purchase this one. And I really like it, but I think that in terms of daytime citrusy summer fragrances, there's probably other ones that I would like. And I think once I use this one up, I will just explore more from the house of Hermes rather than getting the same one. So this one, I would say no, I would not repurchase. Lancôme Le Vieil Belle, this one I would repurchase. This is such a nice, easy, go-to, perfect woman's fragrance. I know some people will dispute that and will give their opinions and say that they think it's too generic or it's too overdone or it's too sweet or too this or too that. Honestly, you guys, I love this fragrance DNA. I think it is one of the most perfectly blended female fragrances on the market. That's why it's so popular, and I really, really like it. I think this is this is kind of a staple in my wardrobe. So yes, I would repurchase Le Vieil Belle. Paul Carabon Olympia, 100% I would repurchase. I love this scent, you guys know. By the way, I'm not going to go too much into detail with notes and stuff like that. I'll just tell you like a small blurb about each one or else we'll be here literally for hours. But this is a salty vanilla fragrance. I love it. I would 100% repurchase this one. This is great for summer daytime, great for dates. Women like it, men like it. It's phenomenal. So yes. Michael Kors Wonderlust. Yes, I would repurchase this one. I have liked this one since it first came out. This is a gorgeous summer, sweet, cozy, nutty, vanilla-y kind of a fragrance, and I absolutely love it. Yes, I would 100% repurchase this one. Prada Candy Eau de Parfum, the original. Yes, I love this fragrance. This is such a beautiful, sweet, makeup-y, caramely, vanilla, powdery fragrance, and I absolutely love it. I think it's very classy, and I really, really love the way this smells. So yes, we would repurchase that one. Mont Guerlain Eau de Parfum, the original. Yes, I love this fragrance. This one is on my top 10 for life fragrances. And I also really like the intense version. So yes, 100% I would repurchase Mont Guerlain. Dolce & Gabbana Garden. This one, I will say no, I would not repurchase. I wore it the other day and I actually really like it, but I'm kind of on the fence about it in terms of its performance. I had to spray myself like 10 or 11 times. Yeah, I really love the way it smells. I really, really do, but I think there's probably better, longer lasting fragrances that have better sillage and better projection. I would not repurchase this one. I am enjoying it and I will probably use it up unless I find something to replace it with. Chanel Chance Eau de Parfum, the original. Yes, I would 100% repurchase this one. I love this fragrance. I think it's so classy. It's perfect for daytime, perfect for the office, all year round. Excellent signature scent. It's beautiful. Coco Mademoiselle. Yes, I would repurchase this one. This is such a nice, classy, elegant daytime staple. I think this is kind of a must-have in every woman's wardrobe. It's just very clean. It's very classy and elegant, and it's a little bit sweet, it's a little bit sexy, and it's just beautiful. Also, the bottle is absolutely gorgeous. I mean, look at the bottle. You want this in your collection just to appreciate the bottle, if for nothing else. But Chanel Chance Eau de Toilette. So same thing as the original Chance, but this is the Eau de Toilette version. The notes are actually a little bit different, and yes, I would 100% repurchase this one. Sometimes I even think I like this one better than the Eau de Parfum. This is great for warm days, great for the gym, great for anytime you want to smell really good and really classy, but also just fresh. Layered First Kiss exclusive. 100% I would repurchase. This is a dupe for Delina exclusive. I love this fragrance so much, you guys. This is a very sweet, woody, gourmand floral fragrance. It has a little bit of oud. It smells like it's got chocolatey notes in it. I don't think there is chocolate in here, but that's what I pick up. There's also lychee, so it's a little bit tart and a little bit fruity. It's just honestly one of the most heavenly fragrances I've ever smelled. Christian Dior Miss Dior Eau de Parfum. Now this one also I've mentioned before, I believe is still the older version, the one that came out in 2012. I would repurchase this one. I think I've told you guys before, I am tempted to go and buy a backup because where I bought this one, they told me they're still working on older stock. So I don't even think they have the new 2017 ones out at this point. And yeah, I would be very, very disheartened if I ran out of this one. So this is also in my top 10 for life. I would 100% go out and repurchase Miss Dior if I was to run out. Okay, moving on to the ones that I have on my current nighttime tray. These are the ones that I like to reserve more for dates, sultry evening, that kind of thing. And I just pulled out a few of them that I wanted to concentrate on wearing at the moment because I have quite a few evening fragrances that are good for winter. So I think all the ones on this tray are repurchases, but we'll go through them one by one. Anyways, Alien. Yes, I would repurchase. You guys know this is one of my top favorite fragrances ever. This is a woody jasmine amber fragrance, and it's very unique, and you've probably smelled it before, and I just love it. Chanel Coco Noir, yes, I would repurchase. This is like the epitome of sultry, sexy, sophisticated, classy woman. So 100% I would repurchase Coco Noir. Marc Jacobs Decadence. This one took a while to grow on me. I actually smelt it a couple of years ago, didn't really love it, came back to it, and now I'm absolutely in love with it. It's so sweet, and it's so green and unique. It's just a very, very sultry evening, strong, unique women's fragrance, but very, very sexy at the same time, and I absolutely love it. I haven't been wearing it as much lately because of the hot weather. Christian Dior Dior Addict. Yes, I really like this one. This is a very mature, sophisticated, but sultry women's fragrance. It's beautiful. It's a vanilla floral, kind of an oriental fragrance, and I love it. It's got sandalwood. It's got like a really creamy vibe about it. Tonka bean. Oh, it's just beautiful, you guys. Yes, I would 100% repurchase Dior Addict. And Viva La Juicy Gold Couture. Yes, I would repurchase this one. This one also took me a while to get on the bandwagon about because I'd heard so much about it and so many people said it was super sultry, super sexy. Men loved it. Finally, I bought a bottle and you guys, I'm hooked. I love it. It's very sweet, very sexy, very caramel. I do have to look past the bottle because I'm not a huge fan of the bottle. And sometimes I feel like this isn't the classiest fragrance to wear. It's a little bit young. But I really, really like it, and it does go over well on date nights. So yes, I would repurchase Gold Couture from Viva La Juicy. Okay, so this entire organizer is also full of perfumes, except for the middle drawer, but the top two and the bottom two drawers are full. So let's try to make this quick, and let's go through this one by one as well. So first we have a little 10 mil travel size of Montel Intense Cafe. Would I repurchase this? Yes, I would. This is a really beautiful rose vanilla coffee fragrance that would be great for the winter. So yes, I would repurchase this one. Here we have another travel size of Tom Ford Orchid Soleil. Would I repurchase this? Yes, I really like this fragrance. Haven't had a chance to wear it yet this summer, but I think I'm actually going to keep it out and put it on my tray and try it for tonight and see how I like it, because I really do like this one. It's strong, it's long lasting, and it does have kind of those coconutty summer vibes, but it's very unique. So yeah, I would repurchase this one. Here we have a 10 mil travel size of Mancera Oud Vanille from Fragrance Net, actually. No, I would not repurchase this one because it's a little bit strong. My boyfriend finds it a little headache inducing, and I have other oud fragrances that I like better. Okay, so in this drawer we have my Chanel babies, some more of my Chanel babies. So we have Chanel No. 5 Eau Première. Yes, I would repurchase this. This is like a more modern, wearable, softer version of the original Chanel No. 5, and I love it. I'm addicted to those aldehydes. I like the powderiness, and I actually wear this one to bed quite a bit. I alternate between this one and the original. So yes, I would definitely repurchase Eau Première if I ran out. We also have the Chanel No. 5 Low. This one I would repurchase as well. This is like the original Chanel No. 5, but it is much lighter, more modern, And we have the original Chanel No. 5 Eau de Parfum. Yes, I would repurchase. I really love this. Even though it's not very modern and it's not very youthful or whatever, it's still such a classy fragrance. And I like to wear this one to bed as well. And I do think this is kind of a classic staple in any woman's perfume collection. So yes, I would repurchase the original Chanel No. 5. Chanel Allure Eau de Parfum. Yes, I would repurchase. This is one of the classiest, most perfect fragrances I've ever smelled in my life. I absolutely love it. It's right up there, one of my favorites, probably in my top 10 for life, although I haven't done an updated top 10 for life video. But yeah, this one I would 100% repurchase. Sarah Jessica Parker Lovely. No, I would not repurchase this one, only because this is very similar to some of the Narciso Rodriguez fragrances, but I actually have other Narciso fragrances that I prefer more than this one. Narciso Rouge, I just talked about this one in a sexy fragrances video. This is one of my favorite sultry, sexy evening fragrances. 100% I would repurchase this one if I ran out. It is one of my absolute favorites. Narciso Poudre, another beautiful, musky, kind of a tonka bean fragrance. Really nice for the winter. This is like the perfect winter day fragrance if you want to smell musky and feminine and sweet. There's also some woody notes in here. It's like the absolute best daytime winter fragrance. I love it. So yes, Narciso Poudre, I would repurchase. Narciso by Narciso, yes, I would repurchase this one as well. To me, this is also a really perfect fall and winter daytime fragrance. It's musky and it's cedary, and when it dries down on your skin, it just has the most beautiful woody, musky, feminine quality about it, and I absolutely love it. And all of the Narciso fragrances I also find to be very long lasting, especially on the clothes. Erin Hibiscus Palm. This one I am on the fence about. I don't think I would repurchase it because, again, I think there's other summery kind of coconutty fragrances that might be better than this one. I really want to try Tom Ford's Soleil Blanc, so we'll see. Gucci Rush, I don't mind this one. I actually really like it. It has kind of a strange synthetic but kind of a sexy quality about it. For now, I would say no, I would not repurchase it because I do have other fragrances. Oh my gosh, it looks so dirty. I do have other fragrances that I would rather wear in the evening time than this one. Dolce & Gabbana The One. Yes, I would repurchase this one. This is actually already a repurchase. This is the second bottle that I have ever owned, and it's a really beautiful, creamy, sophisticated, but very sultry fragrance. I think this is perfect for a special occasion, date night, anniversary dinner. Dolce & Gabbana The Only One. I would say no, I would not repurchase this one, only because it is so close to Black Opium, and I think I like Black Opium a little bit better. Mont Guerlain Eau de Toilette. I would not repurchase this one, although I really like this for summer, and it's a really easy grab-and-go fragrance when you don't know what to wear. You may as well just use the Eau de Parfum. They smell pretty much the same. Victor and Rolf Flower Bomb Dew. This is a really nice fragrance, but I've told you guys it does not have the longevity, and I also prefer the original Victor and Rolf Flower Bomb. This was a blind buy, and no, I would not purchase this one again. In hindsight, I should have just purchased another bottle of the original Victor and Rolf Flower Bomb. Mont Guerlain Intense, 100% I would repurchase this. This is so delicious and so sultry and so seductive. I just love it. This is like a sweeter, more gourmand version of the original Mont Guerlain. So if you can imagine Mont Guerlain Eau de Parfum, twice the tonka bean, twice the vanilla, just really super intensified. It's gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous. So yes, I would repurchase this one. Azzaro Wanted Girl. Yes, I would repurchase this, but I would repurchase it in a larger bottle. This is a 30 ml, and I'm kicking myself that I did not make sure it was a 50 ml first. Swiss Arabian Chagoff Oud. Yes, I would repurchase this. This is a dupe for Lancome Oud Bouquet, and I have a sample of Lancome Oud Bouquet, you guys, and this is pretty much 100% a dupe. They have exactly the same notes. They're pretty much the same, and this is a steal of a deal, excellent price, lasts for a really long time, and I love it. So yes, I would absolutely repurchase Chagoff Oud. Guerlain Encelance Eau de Toilette. Yes, I would repurchase this one. I actually really like the fragrance, even though I don't wear it a whole lot because it's very, very unique, and I think there's a time and a place for it, but this is like a powdery, candied violet fragrance, and if for no other reason, I would repurchase it for the bottle because it's absolutely gorgeous. I love it. And I think that I will eventually wear this a little bit more often at some point. It's beautiful. The scent is beautiful and the bottle is beautiful. Victor and Rolf Flower Bomb Eau de Parfum, the original. Yes, I would repurchase this. In fact, this one has already gone off and people keep telling me it's not off just because the color has changed. And I'm aware of that. It actually smells like it's gone bad. This is about 5 or 6 years old and it's been sitting in the light and I have not been protecting this from heat or from anything. And yes, this has gone off. I 100% would repurchase this and I will repurchase it. This is one of my absolute favorite women's fragrances of all time. Angel Eau de Toilette. This one I would say right now, no, I would not repurchase only because there are other patchouli fragrances that I actually really like. And since I've kind of started to explore the perfume world, I found other patchouli fragrances that I like better than this one. And I still really like this one and I think I will wear it during the winter time, but I would like to explore some more of the Angel flankers, like the Eau Crassier. I would really like to try that one. Eau Sucre. I think there's a few other ones that might be a little bit more up my alley. So at this point in time, I would say I would not repurchase this one. I would go and explore some more of the Angel flankers. Angel Muse from Mugler. I would say at this point in time, no, I would not repurchase this one. This is a really good powdery fragrance and it's very nice, but I don't think I would repurchase it just because I have, again, other more gourmand fragrances that I would rather wear than this one. Armani C. Fiori. No, I would not repurchase this one. It's beautiful. It's a very nice vanilla, kind of a black currant or blackberry, I can't remember which fragrance. It does have that original Armani C DNA and it's very nice, but I would not repurchase it because I have other fragrances that I like a lot more than this one. So it's pretty, I'll try to use it up, and it's a really nice kind of like everyday go-to fragrance, but at this point in time, I would say no, I don't think I would repurchase this one. Oscar de la Renta Bella Rosa. This has been in so many videos I've done because I really, really like it. It's a beautiful fragrance, but also the bottle is very pretty. I would say no, I would not repurchase this one, mostly because the performance is terrible. If you don't spray this on your clothes, you pretty much lose all of your sillage within the first half an hour to an hour max. Really does not perform very well, and yeah, that's a deal breaker for me. So even though it's very pretty and the bottle is beautiful, I would not repurchase this one. Tiffany & Co. Intense. Yes, I would repurchase this one in a heartbeat. This is a really glamorous, sweet, kind of a bedazzled smelling fragrance. I've told you guys before that this reminds me of a birthday cake, but somehow combined with fancy jewelry and diamonds, and it just smells sweet, but it's got like a glamorous edge to it. To me, this is very special occasion, going out in a nice dress with my significant other, very pretty, kind of a glamorous fragrance. And yes, I would 100% repurchase it. Also, the bottle is stunning. It looks like a diamond. So yeah, I would repurchase this. La Vie Belle Éclat. This is a sweeter, more intense, less powdery version of the original La Vie Belle, which I already like. So yes, I would repurchase this one. This one has a little bit more of a citrusy opening. It's got that bergamot in there, which makes it a little bit kind of punchier and more citrusy in the beginning. It's very sexy. It's very sweet. Has excellent performance. Yes, this one I would 100% repurchase. Shalimar Soufflé de Parfum. This was one of my most successful blind buys during quarantine. This one has some of the original Shalimar DNA, which is kind of a very spicy, vanilla, incense-y kind of a fragrance to it, but this also is a lot lighter, more modern, more wearable. It's sweeter and it has a lot of lemon. So this smells kind of like an incense-y, spicy, lemon, cookie, kind of a bakery scent. I've had a few people purchase this based on my review and it's mixed reviews. This is not really a safe blind buy. I wouldn't say go out and buy it today, but I would definitely purchase this again. This is gorgeous and I cannot wait to wear this during the fall. Al Haramain Amber Oud Rouge. I just featured this in a video comparing this to Baccarat Rouge 540. This one, you guys, is like 99% similar to Baccarat Rouge 540. Would I purchase it again? Not for myself. I would give this to my boyfriend or to somebody else who likes Baccarat Rouge 540. To be honest, I'm not head over heels in love with Baccarat Rouge 540. I know some people are like, they're gonna think I'm crazy. That's okay. I don't get all the hype around it. It is not one of my favorite fragrances. So honestly, like, I could give this away and I would be okay with it. It's a very nice fragrance, but I would not repurchase it for myself. Madonna Truth or Dare. No, I would not repurchase this. This is a really beautiful magnolia, gardenia, jasmine fragrance. It's primarily gardenia. It smells just like a gardenia candle that you might find at like Bath & Body Works or HomeSense. Like, it's a very strong, realistic floral fragrance. It's a beautiful fragrance. They did a really good job, but I would not buy this to wear for myself. In fact, I don't even know if I will end up wearing it. It's really pretty, but no, I would not repurchase it. Jean Paul Gaultier La Belle. No, I would not repurchase this one. It's nice. It's a pear, vanilla, and vetiver fragrance, but I would not repurchase it because I have other vanilla fragrances that I like better than this one, and it's just a little bit not complex enough for me. I would prefer something with a little bit more personality, something with some more spices or woody notes, or just something to make it a little bit deeper and more complex. So even though it's beautiful and the bottle is really cute, this one is one that I kind of just want to use up as quickly as I can, and I would not repurchase this one. Viva La Juicy Bodacious. This one was also in my video that I did about perfumes that men like. I would not repurchase this, and the reason being I prefer the Gold Couture over this one. If I was going to get another one that wasn't the Gold Couture, I think I would check out the Pink Couture. I think it's called Pink Couture. It is a little bit more of a grown-up, if you can even call any of the Viva La Juicy's grown-up. It's a little bit more of a grown-up version of this one, and it still has that like Viva La Juicy DNA, but it's a little bit stronger and not so youthful smelling. So yeah, I would not repurchase this one. I'd probably get the Pink Couture. Jessica Simpson Fancy. Yes, I would repurchase this. This is already a repurchase. It is the second bottle that I've owned. This is a really cozy, warm, kind of a skin-like caramel fragrance. Very different from the Gold Couture from the Viva La Juicy line, but it's very, very nice. So yes, I would definitely repurchase this one, especially for the price. You can't beat it. The bottle is beautiful. It looks very antique, and this whole 100ml bottle is only about $25 or $30. So yes, I would repurchase Jessica Simpson Fancy. Annick Goutel's Tenue de Soirée. This is a niche fragrance that I blind purchased in the very, very early times during quarantine. I would not repurchase this again. It's beautiful. It's very, very beautiful, but I would look for something that was a little bit stronger and had better projection and better longevity. This is really pretty, but it's very, very light. It's very soft. I would rather go with something like Petite Robe Noire Intense from Guerlain, which will be coming up shortly here. Or I would get like Nuit et Confidence, which is also from Annick Goutel, but is a lot stronger and lasts longer. Prada Candy Night. This is a very powdery, chocolatey evening fragrance, and I actually really, really like this one. I like all of the Prada candies for the most part, but yeah, I would repurchase this one because, and I think it has, like, people are gonna think I'm crazy, but I think this has some sort of an element of class to it. I think that anytime you smell a little bit makeup-y and powdery, it's just very pretty and very sophisticated, and I really like it. So yes, I would repurchase Prada Candy Night. Jimmy Choo by Jimmy Choo. I really like this one. I would say at this point in time, I would not repurchase it because I do have other fragrances that I prefer to wear for dates over this one, but it is a beautiful fragrance, and it might end up becoming one of those lifers. At this point in time, I don't think I would repurchase it. I think I would explore other evening alternatives, like maybe some of the By Killians or something like that. Frisoise Blondine. Yes, I would repurchase this. This was also a blind buy. I absolutely love it. This is a very cozy, warm leather fragrance. There's also notes of lily. I think it's lily. It could be orchid, but I think it's lily. There's butter. There is warm, cozy, gourmand notes. And then there's also that leather. So super cozy. This is one you could wear either in like a nice warm cabin when you're cuddling with your significant other, but you could also wear this with a little black dress going out. Very versatile, and it's gorgeous, and yeah, I love it. Armani Code Cashmere. Yes, I would repurchase. This is actually already a repurchase. This is a very sultry, sexy, very strong, very well-performing evening fragrance. Incredibly sexy, and I love it. Yes, I would repurchase this. I cannot wait to wear this for date nights during the winter. Dior Hypnotic Poison. Again, yes, I would repurchase. This is already a repurchase. Almondy Vanilla, sultry, cozy, perfect for winter, perfect for fall. Black Opium from Yves Saint Laurent. This one, I will say for now, I would not repurchase because, as I said, I want to venture out and try a few more evening fragrances. I've been really liking something that has a lot of uniqueness and personality, something like Velvet Orchid from Tom Ford, Coco Noir, something that is a little bit stronger. So I do really like Black Opium, but I will just work my way through this bottle, and at this point in time, I would not go out and repurchase this if it ran out. Guerlain Shalimar of the original Eau de Parfum. No, I would not repurchase because I don't think I will ever have to repurchase it because I don't think I'll ever wear it. The reason I bought it was because I really wanted it in my collection. When I first started getting into fragrances, I really wanted some kind of antique vintage fragrances in my collection that had a story behind them and that had been around for a long time. So this is more of a collector's piece. And I have to say, I'm not one of these people who collects fragrances. I like to have fragrances that I actually wear. But this one is one of those kind of collector pieces that I just like to have in my collection. So no, I won't have to repurchase this because I'm just planning to keep it. Dolce & Gabbana L'Impératrice. No, I would not repurchase this. This was a blind buy from FragranceNet. Thank goodness it only cost me, I think, $30 Canadian because I don't think I will ever wear this. This basically just smells like kiwi, watermelon, rhubarb, fruity kind of a shampoo thing, and it is not my vibe, and I do not think I will ever wear this. I really like the bottle. I don't mind using it for a decoration or something, but yeah, I will not repurchase this. Okay, we are getting closer to the end, you guys. This is La Petite Robe Noir Intense from Guerlain. Yes, I would repurchase this. This is a really pretty blueberry cotton candy fragrance, but it's also a little bit more complex. There is some bergamot and there's quite a few other notes in here. This has excellent performance and it's very sweet, but also very mature and very sexy. Olympia Aqua. No, I would not repurchase it because I prefer the original Olympia. I also prefer the original Olympia to any of the other flankers that I have smelled. So this one, I don't even know if I'm going to end up wearing it because to me, this is just a lighter, fresher version of the original. Lancôme La Nuit Trésor. No, I would not repurchase this. This fragrance is really nice. It's kind of a fruity, sultry gourmand. This is on so many people's like most sexy list, date night list, etc., etc. It was blown up all over the internet. I think the reason I actually bit the bullet and bought this blindly was because of Jeremy Fragrance, because it was in one of his sexiest perfumes for women videos. And then I also heard Demi Rawling talk about it. I heard quite a few people. So finally, I just went out and bought it. And when I first bought it, I was in love with it. I have not worn this since I've purchased it. It just never ends up being the one that I grab for, even though it's beautiful. I never, ever, ever grab for this fragrance. So no, I think this was a little bit overhyped. This beautiful bottle, Tom Ford Noir Parfum. Yes, I would repurchase this. I really, really like it. It's a very deep, dark, sultry, kind of a gourmand fragrance, and I absolutely love it. I think it's a very confident, attention-grabbing, compliment-getting fragrance for women, and I also really like the bottle. And I also really like a lot of Tom Ford's fragrances in general. So yes, I would repurchase Tom Ford Noir Parfum. Versace Crystal Noir. No, I would not repurchase this one. This is actually the second time I've purchased this. I used to have it in my collection many, many years ago. And this is a really nice, kind of a cool-smelling evening coconutty, kind of a spicy, peppery fragrance for women. It's very sultry and it's very nice, but if I was going to wear something like this, I would choose Coco Noir from Chanel before I would choose this one. They're kind of like the same vibe. They're both evening, they're both spicy, but the Coco Noir is just more. It's just something more for me. So yeah, I would not repurchase Versace Crystal Noir. J'adore from Dior. At this point in time, I will say no, I would not run out and repurchase this one. I have other daytime fragrances that I would rather wear, although this is a really beautiful, easy to go to daytime fragrance, but I think this one will actually end up lasting me a really long time just because I don't wear it that frequently. This is really nice, but at this point in time, I would say no, I would not run out and repurchase it. And last but not least, Mancera Roses Vanille. Oh no, not last, I have Delina. I would absolutely repurchase this. This is absolutely gorgeous. This is my favorite, favorite, favorite rose and vanilla fragrance. It's so sweet. It literally smells like sugared roses. I don't know how to explain it. It's just absolutely mouthwatering, so good, so long-lasting, projects really well. It's just beautiful. I cannot wait for fall so I can wear some of these fragrances. So yes, Mancera Roses Vanille may become a lifer. Okay. This is the last one, Delina by Parfums de Marly, and this is the original Eau de Parfum. I did not actually purchase this. This was a trade, believe it or not. I traded with one of my beautiful subscribers who couldn't wear this because it gave her a headache. So we traded perfumes. And so yeah, I did not actually pay for this one. I think I told you guys in previous videos that I wasn't in a hurry to reno and buy Delina. I did have a sample, but you guys, I have to say, this perfume has grown on me more and more every time I smell it. I just think it's so beautiful. Just such a lovely, light, feminine rose fragrance. Beautiful for spring, beautiful for summer. Compliment getter, performs really well. Bottle is beautiful. Yeah, this is one that I think is worth the hype. I do really like it. And yes, I would repurchase this if it ran out. That's it for today's video, guys. If you made it to the end, thank you so much for still being here. I really appreciate it. And do head over and follow me on Instagram if you haven't already, because I do share a lot of things on there that I don't on YouTube. And I will see you guys all next time.